Hi, hello everyone. My heartfelt thanks to you all the viewers, my friends, colleagues, relatives and my students, my favorite alumni for having watched and commented my videos with a positive outlook is really a welcoming sign for me. I still further request you all please continue watching my videos and shed your love on my videos till my proverb sessions complete. Let us come to our present proverb, today's proverb, the first proverb, attitude determines altitude. Let me show you the gentleman, the inventor of this all-time wonderful proverb in a slide. Let us watch the gentleman's slide, please. The gentleman you can see here is one of the world's most popular American authors and motivational speakers. He is the inventor of this famous proverb, "Your attitude determines your altitude," is none other than Mr. Zig Ziglar. Thank you for watching the gentleman, Zig Ziglar, the inventor of the present today's proverb. Now, I let you know what your proverb is. A proverb is a simple, concrete and traditional saying that offers us a perceived truth based on common sense. Proverbs, often called as metaphorical, proverbs are used as formulaic expressions. Proverbs offer us timeless wisdom for our everyday living. We can see our circumstances in the light of the wisdom that is obtained from the practice of reading the proverbs. Now I would like to explain the present proverb, its effect on human life. How does it work in our life? Yes, we all face many problems, many obstacles, ups and downs in our life. Life is not a bed of roses. We have to face them bravely and boldly. And people who are in distress trying to end their life, it is not the correct. It is not correct decision. One must agree that the fortune of a man depends upon his own self. If a person, take for example of hard worker. A hard worker, when he makes the best use of his talent, can come up in his life. It highlights Shramaiva Vijayate. Hard work, willpower and perseverance are the three basic elements, glorious elements that can work in our life. If a person wastes his time, all his time, in mere wishful thinking, expects miracles to transform his life. Horses, wishes are not horses. If wishes were really horses, beggars only would ride. No one can hope for success without doing anything. Our present proverb, attitude determines altitude, is very much apt for the two legendaries. They are Oscar Pistorius, the famous South African sprinter, and the Sudha Chandran, the famous Indian classical dancer. Let us watch their slides. Oscar Pistorius, the South African sprinter, without fibula bones, born in Johannesburg, South Africa, in November 22, 1986. His two legs were amputated below knee using prosthetic legs. He became an accomplished athlete. He won 200 meter gold and 100 meter bronze at the Paralympics. He is famously known as Blade Runner, the fastest man on no legs. His best record was 45.07 seconds in 400 meters. Sudha Chandran, an Indian film actress and a popular accomplished Bharatanatyam dancer whose life was standing as a role model for her struggle to set back to lead a normal life,
though her leg was amputated in 1981. It was her unfortunate incident that took place in 1981 while she was traveling in a car. She met with an accident and her leg was amputated. She did not give up her decision of becoming a great dancer. She was determined, and later she emerged as an accomplished Bharatanatyam dancer with her willpower.
We have watched up to now the famous personalities, Pistorius and Sudachandra. Their lives tell us how they overcame all of their obstacles and how they transformed their misfortune into fortune with their willpower, hard work and perseverance. Final flash. A person who realizes the worth of the time and puts forth all of his efforts can become the architect of his own fortune. Thank you. I personally believe that these two legendaries will stand as live examples for our present proverb. Thanks for watching, subscribe and press the bell icon. And I personally feel that I want to put a word to all the students and upcoming teachers. When you practice these proverbs, and they will definitely set us a moral behavior, moral standards. Teachers who introduce these proverbs in their classes, 5 minutes if they dedicate their time before they start a lesson, children will also get ready for the moral values that teachers explain them. So teachers take up this idea of explaining proverbs in the classroom before you start your class. Thank you very much.